I am Keisha Wilson Tanner. I've worked for BP for 22 and a half years. I am currently the area planning team lead for the Thunder Horse facility. My team is responsible for pouring a strategic plan for the operations, drilling, and major project operations that are going on the facility. And this morning is one of my favorite days of the year. It's an opportunity for us to talk to about 1,300 female students about the oil industry.
I'm Brittany Salop, and I'm an in-house attorney for Chevron. And we're presenting to sophomores in high school, groups of women who are interested in learning about the energy industry and STEM fields.
I'm Yvette Archuleta Tutori, and I have Vast Industries, which is a machining and fabrication firm in Morgan City, Louisiana. I was elated to come share my story with these girls, and it just started drawing me that I want to give to these people. I want to show them that this is a big old world and a great career choice that doesn't get much exposure unless they have a family member that's in product design or manufacturing. They don't really understand it or even see what goes on in our daily life. So I encourage them to come out, visit the shop.
My name is Maria Sevillano. I am a non-operated health, environment, and safety advisor for Chevron Gulf of Mexico. I think it was not only an opportunity for me to share my experience, but also appreciate some of the questions that a lot of the young kids have.
It's very important for us to have partners like Fletcher Technical Community College to work with the HOMA Learning Center here with BP to provide a day such as this. How I wish I would have had something like this in high school. I would have decided to be an engineer a lot sooner and consider the oil industry sooner. But it's just a great opportunity to see their eyes light up when they say, "You fly offshore?" Yes, I do.
It's really exciting to see the light bulb come on for some of these young ladies as you talk about the industry and the positive experiences we've had with the industry and what a good place it is for women. You see them ask a lot of good questions and really start to think about whether they could find a career in the same industry, which we're fortunate to have a lot of here on the Gulf Coast.
Every time I speak to every group, I say, enjoy what you're going to choose as your career. Be passionate about it and let it challenge you, because you're going to spend 90% of your life doing it. So please like what you choose.
What I wanted to do is convey a message of encouragement for girls to study STEM-related fields, and just a little bit of advice that I've found helpful throughout my journey. There's no such thing as, oh, it's a woman's field or it's a man's field. It's an equal opportunity field. With anything that you decide to do in life, you have to put in the work, put in the time. If you do that, you will accomplish your goals and you will be successful.
Just because you haven't seen anyone work in an industry or attempt to achieve whatever it is, what does that have to do with you? Somebody's waiting on you to be the first.
I'm hopeful that our discussion today encouraged them that investment in yourself for undergraduate and for graduate school really is worth it. The best advice that I think many of us have shared with them is to reach out and connect with people in the industry, women in particular, and in the fields they're interested in. There are great internship programs and learning events like this. And my experience has always been that women, especially in the energy industry, are more than happy to share their positive experiences and connect with younger women and try to get them interested in joining our field.
I told them to be whatever they want to be, to go ahead and do what they want to do, regardless of family, regardless of friends, that they can do it. If they think they can, they might have to have a little bit of tough skin, and they might have to hear a couple of no's, but to actually be aggressive enough to chase their dream. And I think that I might have had a couple glimmers of light in a few of them, which I'm hoping.
Education is going to give you the tools to become that professional or to get to that point in your life where you want to be. It is really important for us to share those obstacles and challenges that they might encounter and share our perspective of how we overcame that.
Our industry fuels the world, so it's exciting to be part of that, and it's exciting to be on the cutting edge of technological advances and be part of an industry that touches everybody in their everyday lives. It's just really inspiring to see all the young women, they're, you know, sophomores in high school, and they're really thinking critically about their careers and asking some really insightful questions. Community partnerships between places like Fletcher and industry members is critically important, and that ongoing dialogue to develop these relationships and work together to provide programming that, that benefits the young people in the communities where we live and work is so valuable for everyone, is really critical.
And it is, for me, very rewarding that possibly this conversation would bring more people into the industry. I always say, if one person seriously considers the oil industry after today, it's worth everything.